Udo's right here. You're limping a little bit when you walked up to the stage right now. Physically, how are you feeling after that fight?
Good, yeah. It's been a minute. I had a lot of stuff happen in the past year and few months. I'm happy. You know, I worked really hard. I knew that things have to come together at some point. I'm doing the right thing day in, day out. It has to come together, you know. And if it doesn't, it's still fine. I don't get disappointed because, again, I'm doing the right thing for me, for my family, for the team. So, yeah, I'm happy. That's all I can say.
What was going on with your life in the last few months?
I had a surgery on my hand. I had an injury. It's a long time. It's an old injury, right? I was dragging it, and I knew it's going to have to get a surgery at some point. I had it when I fought Turner, like 2 weeks out. I couldn't really punch with my left hand, you know. It heals up, gets better. I fought more, after that. I fought again. I won. Then I booked another fight, and 4 weeks out of the fight, I heard it probably the worst time ever heard it. And I heard it many times. I thought, okay, it's gonna heal up, and maybe I'll be able to train again. 4 weeks, 5 weeks later, gets better. I go train for a week. Boom, heard it again, and it gets much worse. And that's when we started looking into getting a surgery. I did treatments to try and treat it. It's a joint that got injured between the two bones. So I didn't break it, but the joint got smashed between the bones. So what they had to do is pull a piece of bone from lower in my wrist, and then they inserted that piece of bone in between the bones where the joint is and fused it with the titanium. And now it's good. It's not the same as it was, but it's good. You know, this hand, I've had so many injuries on it, but it's still bringing it home, you know? So I'm happy.
So with that injury and the surgery, in the actual fight itself, did you feel anything in there at all with that hand, or did you feel like a different fighter, a new fighter?
It feels same. It's hurting a little bit right now. It's swollen. I can see it already. But it's not hurting where I had the surgery, so I'm pretty confident that it's going to be okay.
In the actual fight, a tough first round, came back to win. We heard his corner. His corner says that they think you won the second round, that he would have to come out quickly in the third mm-hmm. to possibly pull out a decision. I'm curious, how did the fight play out from your preparation to what actually went down?
I wasn't too concerned about what's going on, who's winning, who's losing. I tried to focus on what do I need to do to get to put a good performance, right? I need to stay composed, you know, get my combinations in, do my defense, stay on the outside, don't gas myself out. We're at the altitude. Those are the things that were going through my mind, you know, take deep breaths, stay calm. And, things just came together. I started hurting him to the body.
Yeah.
I think I saw it on him a little bit. He did have a good poker face, so I think I hurt him even earlier, but he was showing. And, when the finish was there, I, as I said in a previous interview over there, I didn't see the footage yet. I don't know exactly what happened. I did get rocked. Yeah. I found myself on my back. I got up. I did sneak in some shots from the ground with my up kicks, as I remembered. And then in the second round, I think I even dropped him kicking up.
Yep.
Here we are.
And that 1-2 followed by the spinning back fist, thick elbow, you kind of hit him with your forearm. Is that something you practiced for this fight, or did you just
if you guys remember, Beniel Dariush had a finish just a few years ago.
And Scott Holtzman.
I mean, we train. That's my main training partner. I love him to death, just like all the guys at Kings MMA. We train so hard together. They've all had my back, whatever, you know. It's been a year that I didn't fight, and they've all trained with me, whatever I needed, whenever I needed. Benny went through hell and back, lost his fight against Charles. So many things happened in that camp. I was a witness. Not really going to get into details because he didn't either. Charles was the better man that night. But that wasn't Benny that I know, and I wish I could get that fight back for him as the Benny that I know. I think Benny beats him 9 out of 10 times. And that was that one of those times. And I was saying in previous interview, it's not comparable to any other sport. When you have an off night, the other guys I scored 10 points instead of 30 tonight. You know, for us, you get your ass handed to you in front of everybody to see, and then everybody point a finger and like, he lost the fight. But it just happened to be that kind of night for him, and it happens to everybody. So it happened to me once, it happens to the best in the world. It just happens.
So final question for me for with about you and Beniel. What would you like for both of your careers moving forward, like for your next fight?
I just keep winning. I mean, keep working hard, keep winning. We both love to fight. You guys should see us train together. It's always a great training session, a lot of laughs. It's just, I miss him. I haven't seen him. I've been here 3 weeks. I can't wait to be back. Giga just got a fight booked after a while. Giga's been working his ass off, training nonstop, and they couldn't get him a fight. And gets booked, gets canceled. There's talk about this, talk about that. Nothing for certain, and now he gets something booked for Singapore. So I can't wait to be back to help Giga out. And I think he's going to do very well because he did upgrade in this time that he had. So, that's my team. You know, we are a bunch of winners. Even when we lose, we're still winners.
Roche, right over here. Mm-hmm. Just to kind of follow up about Beniel Dariush, been a couple months since the Charles Oliveira loss. How's he doing now?
He's doing great. We talked recently. He wished me good luck. He's doing great. He's training. I can see the pictures online on the Instagram. He's training. And I haven't been there for a couple of weeks. I came out here earlier. I'm excited to be back, you know, to see how everybody's doing. Excited to be back in California.
To kind of follow up, being here for 3 weeks, we saw Ramzi Nijem in your corner,
yes.
A Utah legend amongst the state. Yep. What was it like being able to train with him and have him get you ready for your fight?
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, me and Ramzi, we've only known each other for now a couple of weeks, and we're basically best friends. Like, we get along really well. We train hard together. He helped me a lot. He woke up that beast inside of me. You know, he mentioned like things about me leaving home, leaving places, like to do these things, showing up here all by myself, not knowing anybody, to just train and get ready to go fight some dude. So for him, he found inspiration in all of that, and I found the beast inside of me when he mentioned all of that. What he sees in me, I almost forgot what am I even doing? You know, so it's crazy. I'm crazy. Yeah.
You kind of said it over here in the middle. You kind of said it after the fight, just competing in Utah. Take me through what it was like being in Salt Lake City. Did you like fighting here? Did you feel the elevation? Just what did you like or not like about this place?
Yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. I could see myself, I don't know about living in the city, but I would like to live here in the state of Utah. And I think I've spent some time at the Snowbird. Now he's my friend. We met here. I stayed with him, and while I trained with Ramzi, Ramon is a friend of mine. He let me stay at his place, and he works over in Snowbird. And he showed me around. We went visit resorts. It is so beautiful. Like it reminds me a lot of Alaska, and I've spent 6 years in Alaska. It's super nice. I could see myself spending more time here, especially in the wintertime.
So you like the beauty, but you didn't feel the elevation, or because you?
I did feel
time?
The elevation for sure, especially when I arrived. It's different. It's summertime. It's hot. It's dry. I did feel it. Yeah, I trained hard. I mean, if I feel it, everybody feel it. So what are you gonna do? You know, I'm sure Justin tonight is gonna do well because he does train at elevation year round. I'm excited to see that fight. Unfortunately, they won't let us stay to watch the fights here live, but. But I'm hoping to see it at the hotel. I'm cheering. He's with my management team, Dominance MMA. So I'm hoping Justin wins tonight. It's a big night for everybody. This is a huge fight and a big year overall. 30 years of this. I mean, what a company. I'm 30 years old, and it's just. I can't believe it. When I was a kid, it wasn't my favorite thing to watch live, you know. But then, over the period of time, the regulations, the rules, the you know, everything kind of changed and came together into this wonderful sport. I'm very blessed to be here and thankful for the opportunity.
I went back here real quick. You just said it yourself. 30 years old, 30th anniversary. You're gonna try and get on that 30th anniversary card later this year?
I would like to. When is it, the 30th anniversary?
Oh, I think it's 295 in November, right?
November, yeah. I would like to. Why not? I mean, why not? If I'm healthy, if I'm ready, let's go. I would hope to fight in Paris. This is what I wanted. Because then I can go to Europe and see my family and see everybody. I do need UFC to help me out with my immigration so I can sort that out. I'm good here, but for some reason, I'm still waiting on the travel documentation to be sorted out. And immigration system is not the fastest system working around here. So, and I understand they've got a lot of work to do. So I'm patient, but again, at some point, I'm like, what's going on? You know, where do we begin and where does it end?